Blessed is the man who remains steadfast under trial. For when he has stood the test, he will receive the crown of life, which God has promised to those who love him. And after you have suffered a little while, the God of all grace, who has called you to his eternal glory in Christ, will himself restore, confirm, strengthen, and establish you. Rejoice in hope, be patient in tribulation, and be constant in prayer. I have said these things to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but take heart, I have overcome the world. No temptation has overtaken you that is not common to man. God is faithful, and he will not let you be tempted beyond your ability. But with the temptation, he will also provide the way of escape, that you may be able to endure it. Count it all joys, brothers and sisters, when you meet trials of various kinds. Not only that, but we rejoice in our suffering, knowing that suffering produces endurance. The Lord will fight for you. You have only to be silent. Count it all joys, brothers and sisters, when you meet trials of various kinds, for you know that the testing of your faith produces steadfastness. And let steadfastness have its full effect, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking in nothing. And if any of you lack wisdom, let him ask God, who gives generously to all without reproach, and it will be given to you. But let him ask in faith with no doubting, for the one who doubts is like the waves of the sea that is driven and tossed by the wind. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and do not lean on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will make your path straight. Beloved, do not be surprised at the fiery trials when you come upon you in this world, as though something strange were happening to you. For I consider that the suffering of this present time are not worth comparing with the glory that is to be revealed to us. And we know that for those who love God, all things work together for good, for those who are called according to his purpose. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. I can do all things through whom strengthens me, Christ Jesus. When the righteous cry for help, the Lord hears and delivers them out of all their troubles. The Lord is near to those who are brokenhearted and saves the crushed in spirit. Therefore, do not throw away your confidence, which has such a great reward. In this we rejoice, though now for a little while, if necessary, you have been grieved by various trials. But he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, I boast all the more gladly of my weaknesses, so that the power of Christ may rest upon me. Count it all joy, brother and sister, when you meet trials of various kinds, for you know that the testing of your faith produces steadfastness, and that steadfastness has its full effect, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking in nothing. strengthening the souls of the disciples, encouraging them to continue in faith, and saying that through many trials, we must enter the kingdom of God, so that the tested genuineness of your faith, more precious than gold that perishes, though it is tested by fire, may be found to result in praise and glory and honor at the revelation of Jesus Christ. But Jesus looked at them and said, "With man, this is impossible, but with God, all things are possible. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers them out of them all. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be frightened. Do not be dismayed, for the Lord your God with you wherever you go. Indeed, all who desire to live a godly life in Christ Jesus will be persecuted.